Video 2.4 UART in Nano RP2040 Connect. In this video, we will cover the following topics. What is UART? How UART works? How to send and receive data via UART in Arduino Nano RP2040? A universal asynchronous receiver transmitter, abbreviated as UART, is an IC or a part of an IC that supports serial communication. In the case of microcontrollers, UART peripherals are commonly integrated into microcontroller chips. The function of UART is to convert data, whether incoming or outgoing, into a serial binary stream. Serial-to-parallel conversion is applied on the data coming from a peripheral device, and parallel-to-serial conversion is applied on the data transmitted to peripheral devices. UART is asynchronous, meaning no clock signal is required to synchronize the transmitted and received data. UART is a two-wire communication. Data flows from the TX pin of the transmitting UART device to the RX pin of the receiving UART device. The pins used for UART in Arduino Nano RP2040 boards are D0 as transmitter pin and D1 as receiver pin. In this type of communication, the data format and the baud rate are configurable from both ends. However, the transmitting and receiving UART devices must be set for the same baud rate, character length, parity, and stop bits for proper operation. The baud rate is the rate at which data is transferred to a communication channel. The set baud rate will serve as the maximum number of bits per second to be transferred in the serial port context. UART transmitted data is organized into packets. Each packet contains one start bit, 5 to 9 data bits in a data frame, an optional parity bit, and 1 or 2 stop bits. Start bit. The UART data transmission is by default held at a high logic when no data is being transmitted. The UART pulls the logic from high to low for 1 clock cycle to start data transfer. When the receiver detects a low logic, it starts reading the bits in the data frame. Data frame. The actual data to be transmitted is contained in the data frame, and it can be from 5 bits to 8 bits long if no parity is used. However, if parity is used, data can be up to 9 bits. Parity bit. If the parity bit is 0, then it is said to be even parity, and if the parity bit is 1, then it is said to be odd parity. If the parity and the oddness or evenness of the data size do not match, the data frame has changed. Stop bit. The transmitter drives the data line from a low logic to high logic for 1 to 2 bits duration to indicate the end of the data package. All the Arduino boards consist of TX and RX pins on digital pin 0 and 1 respectively. If we want to establish a UART communication between two Arduino boards, connect the transmitter pin of one board to the receiver pin of the other board and connect the receiver pin of the first board with the transmitter pin of the second board. To send and receive data through UART, we first need to set the baud rate inside the void setup function. To set the baud rate for a particular serial monitor, we will command serial1.begin9600. To send data serially via UART, we need to give the command serial1.write message. We can use a while loop to read each character coming via UART and then add the characters to form a complete string. Use a while loop with condition serial1.available. Inside the loop, read each character by using the command serial1.read, then add each character to form a string. That is all, folks, for this video. Video summary. In this video, we have covered the following topics. What is UART? How UART works? How to send and receive data via UART in Arduino Nano RP2040. In the next video, we will learn about the SPI and I2C in Nano RP2040 Connect.